there's nothing quite like watching holiday flicks to get into the spirit of the season. But this year, in addition to the classic Christmas movies that you've all come to know and love, there's a new Lifetime movie that you'll want to add to your list. It's called Wishin and Hopin, and it's based on the best-selling novel by Wally Lamb. We're going to take a quick look.
The Christmas pageant this year. You will be the stars of the show.
I will volunteer to play the Blessed Virgin Mary.
It's time to reveal the casting.
Pauline Papelbon? There must have been some sort of mistake.
So as you can see, viewers are transported back to the 1960s to the fictional town of Three Rivers, Connecticut. It includes an array of stars, including Molly Ringwald, Chevy Chase, and Meatloaf, and a lot of new and upcoming stars as well. The best part about it all, it was shot entirely in our state. Joining me now is the film's director, Colin Thays, and screenwriter, John Doolan. Gentlemen, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having us. This is so exciting.
The whole movie shot right in Connecticut.
Yep.
So give us the overview, if you will.
Okay, Wishin' and Hopin', basically, it's a... not quite coming of age tale of a 10-year-old boy in parochial school in 1964. And things kind of, it's like the most memorable Christmas he's ever had because he gets a new substitute teacher from Quebec, and he also gets like a Russian exchange student. And basically it's kind of him learning the meaning of Christmas through all these series of comical events.
Got it. And Colin, what was it like working with these big names?
Yeah, it was really a great experience, both the cast and with Wally. Wally was involved from the very beginning all the way through the end. He's been going to the premieres with us, and he helped John with the script, and he was on set to see what we were working on, and even in the movie, he's in a cameo in the
first
scene.
Is that right? Oh, we'll have to look for it,
then. At the beginning, he's the janitor, which he picked because he's not very handy. Thought it was funny.
Sure, and there's so many Connecticut connections, which we love. We're excited about. Talk to me about filming and kind of where it took place.
Yeah, filming basically took place in the towns of Norwich, Norwich, Connecticut, which is at the Norwich Free Academy, as well as Willimantic, and we also had a day of shooting at Jewett City. And basically, Wally taught at Norwich Free Academy, and so he kind of set it up that we could film there, and he had our producer Andrew as a student when he taught there. You know, Andrew's from Connecticut. Me and Colin both live in New Haven, so... a lot of Connecticut people there, and Wally lives in Connecticut still, too.
So it'll be great to watch, which is happening this weekend.
Yeah, Saturday at 8.
Very good.
A lot of the kids, too. A lot of the kids in the classroom and in the school are all from
they came to
and
the
what
open
was it like
casting.
Working with the kids? I mean, there was a lot of them to probably wrangle at times.
Working with the kids was, it was a great experience overall, but it was certainly interesting. There was a lot of wrangling cats going on, because there were some days we had as many as 80 kids in the movie at one time.
Very much a learning experience.
They really are 10. Yeah. They're not, you know, 20-year-olds.
Pretending to be 10.
And they had a great time. Like, basically, they thought it was summer camp, and they made T-shirts for themselves with all their names on it.
They were probably so excited to be taking part, right?
Yeah.
Talk to me about Synthetic Cinema International.
Basically, it was founded, I believe, in 2004 by Andrew and his business partners, Bonnie and Rich. And they started off doing little creature features. I think I was an extra in his first movie. And then, you know, he did a couple more movies, and Colin came in as one of his interns. And then right after Colin left, I was his intern. And so we both had kind of been with the company for 8 years now, about? Yeah. So it's... since then, we've made, you know, the other television films for the Chiller Channel, and this is our first kind of foray into non-horror genre.
Got it. And so you shot the movie a while ago, right? Almost a year ago it was in production?
No, we shot it this summer.
You did, in July.
Yeah.
So talk to me about shooting a Christmas movie in July. How'd you get in the holiday spirit?
Well, actually, it's surprisingly easy. Once your whole world looks like Christmas, sounds like Christmas, it feels like Christmas, everybody just starts humming Christmas songs. It just kind of naturally happens. But it was really hot.
Well, I would imagine.
We were in the third floor of a non-air-conditioned building from, you know, 1880 with a bunch of kids in wool coats. And it was, you know, between the takes, you had to go dab the sweat off everyone's face. And the kids would come into the room all excited and then walk in and sit down.
Such a great time of the year, though, right? What happened with the nativity scene?
Okay, so the nativity scene, the main kid, Felix, is supposed to be in the manger pretending to be the baby Jesus, but he didn't fit, so we had to saw a hole through the bottom of the manger so his feet could go through, and then there was a goat and a lamb on stage, and the goat actually jumped into the manger by accident.
Oh, wow.
And
you
Wyatt
know
was
what's
like,
gonna
whoa,
happen.
Hello.
That's great, and I understand you guys are working on another movie, another Christmas movie that's airing next weekend.
That's right.
Pretty busy for you both.
Yeah, they were working on Synthetic Cinema did post-production on the SantaCon, which is directed by Melissa Joan Hart. So that was pretty exciting
stuff
for the company. Yeah.
All right, so the details, we could watch it this weekend, December 6th, 8 o'clock, correct? And there's also some viewing locations at Central and UConn on December 11th.
It's actually Southern.
Southern,
December 4th. Yeah.
Okay, very good. Southern December 4th, and then UConn December 11th, and you guys are going to be on hand to answer some questions?
Yep. Yeah.
Very nice. Well, I can't wait to watch it this weekend. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.